Now, who certifies whether I do it properly? One, because one of the issues which people always talk about is the intent and the content. Content may be good, intent may not be. I can draft it accordingly. Or the intent may be good, but I do not know how to basically put it across. So who does the, you know, checking whether the organization really prescribes to the work that they're talking about?
See, there is a general process which has been followed. It is called the assurance of sustainability report.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And the assurance actually leads to certain kind of trust building, you know, the credibility of the report.
Yeah.
So, but it is not like an audit, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, what has happened here is that most of the organizations who are reporting, they would like to kind of get a third-party assessment done.
Yeah.
So it is not a complete assurance to
mm-hmm.
give complete trust or build, you know, the credibility of the report. But it is more or less based on the data and their, you know, submission of any
yeah.
public domain information which is available, which can say, oh, this is why, you know, the company has reported rightly.
Mm-hmm.
But assurance is beyond, you know, that.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, you know, again, if these assurers actually go back to the using the principles of reporting,
mm-hmm.
that is materiality, stakeholder, and, you know, sustainability and completeness, and looks at the boundary setting of the report,
mm-hmm.
and looks at the six principles of ensuring and the quality of the report, or for example, you know, having neutrality, you know, that is one of the, you know, principles for ensuring quality of the report. So these principles, if they are used in the assurance, then I think sustainability reports become really, really credible.
So third party assurance is not required. It is not mandatory. It is good, but it is not mandatory.
No.
Okay.
It is not mandatory. It is one of the keys to, you know, bring about, a trust building.
Sure, sure.
But I would say if the organization can ensure, use of these principles of reporting in their process,
mm-hmm.
And then I think, you know, the report becomes trustworthy enough.
Yeah.